Business on Board with Carrie Hurford-Jones.
Thank you for joining me on board my floating studio for another Business on Board show as I meet up with more of the people behind the latest tech and apps that are helping us get more out of our time on the water. Today I'm meeting up with Thomas Guy and Chris Jacobs. These are the guys behind SailTies, an app that's becoming known as the Strava for sailing. Basically, what they've created is a modern alternative to the paper logbook. Essentially, it's a place where you can capture all the information about your sailing voyages. Tom has been building mobile apps for over 10 years, but found himself needing a technology detox, so went to work on an olive farm in Tuscany for a couple of months, like you do. Whilst there, he got his first experience of life on a sailboat and absolutely fell in love with it. On returning to the UK, he met his co-founder Chris Jacobs and realised that both had a shared goal, which was to get their day skipper's tickets and sail around the Med. Chris has been designing websites and apps for over 10 years, working with such clients like Sky and Sainsbury's. Over the past couple of years, he's clocked up over 3,000 miles of offshore sailing, delivering boats all over the world. During his working life, he also spent time at Facebook before leaving to join Tom, where they together have brought SailTies to life. Tom, Chris, welcome on board, literally and metaphorically, to this week's podcast.
Thank you.
Hi there. Thank you for having us.
Just give us a quick overview, if you wouldn't mind, of the product itself and the app.
So SailTies is the first modern way for sailors to capture, relive, and share their sailing. So we've been likened to Strava for people who use Strava for cycling and running. And we'd say we're creating a modern alternative to the paper logbook. We're a free app available in the iOS App Store. And essentially, it's the first place where you can capture everything about a sailing voyage together. We make it really simple by using the phone's GPS. So you just have one tap to start and another to finish. And it works completely offline and offshore. So our users have recorded everything from tiny little lakes to full Atlantic crossings. And then once you've done that, we just generate key information automatically for you. So distance, duration, location, those kind of things. And then the sailor can add their own notes and photos on top of that. We've made collaboration a really cool part to the app as well to make capturing the experience even easier. So if the three of us went sailing, I could record it on SailTies, but then Kerry, you and Tom could also add your notes and add your pictures and just build up that richer picture of what happened that day. And then all of us would have it available on our profiles as well. We've made it really easy to share. So any of us could have the option to share the voyage to our public feed. It's also really easy to share this nice image representation of your voyage to social media. Every voyage has a public link as well. So you could just send it a link in a WhatsApp message to family and friends, and they can just open it in their browser if they're not necessarily sailors who want the app. And yeah, every sailor has a profile. So this is just a collection of all the voyages that they've been part of and an automatic summary of their experience. So their stats, like their miles log, their days at sea. So effectively their sailing CV, or that digital version of their logbook.
So really quite a simple concept. Get that. We've been using it. We've been trialing it a few times, as you know, because you can see from your overview position of what people are doing out there. But the bottom line is, why should people use it?
That's a great question. Well, SailTies started organically, to be honest. It wasn't like Tom and I sat down in the pub and decided we want to create a business. It was from when we were sailing. So Tom and I were sailing in 2018, doing our day skipper on the Solent with Nomad Sailing. At the end of the first weekend, the six crew were sitting in the pub in Gosport in the Castle Tavern, writing our logbook entries. We were sharing pictures in a WhatsApp group and trying to describe in words what had happened to family and friends back. And it was really fun, but it felt very manual and tedious. When I'm landlocked, so when I'm not on a boat and I'm cycling, I use Strava to record my cycling. So I was expecting a similar digital experience. So in the second weekend of our course, we tried out all the apps you could imagine. So we tried out Strava and a bunch of other apps and devices. I had my bike computer in my pocket, but nothing worked for sailing. So we realized at that point that this was a product that we wanted, but if we were going to have it, we're going to have to make it ourselves. I think we used a spreadsheet at first, and we've seen loads of other people doing that. But I think the general rule is if people are using a spreadsheet, then there's probably an opportunity to make a great product. There wasn't any sort of market research done at this point, I guess. It was just we had some hypotheses that we really wanted, a couple of friends really into it, but we still had to sort of test out whether it was something that all sailors wanted, which we spent the whole of that sort of summer 2019 doing.
Tom, it must have been quite exciting from your point of view to be involved in something like this right at the very outset.
Yeah, incredibly exciting. I've loved building digital products. I've traditionally been a programmer, but I've also been very, very interested in the product management side of things, and where you kind of get into nuts and bolts of why people use an app and generating real value. The first thing we did was we built some prototypes. We started off with some kind of scrappy paper prototypes and moved on to some more advanced, tappable digital ones afterwards. But we got out to marinas and we tested them with sailors and boaters in the UK, but also on our holidays in Greece. So we're basically bothering people on their flotillas trying to relax with a cocktail. We're shoving these paper prototypes under their face to see if they're interested or not. We were quite lucky though that my wife's a user researcher by trade, so she helped us out a lot. So we've been kind of bootstrapping it so far. That's been incredibly helpful. She knows exactly what to do in that field. So she helped us with our user research, our interviews, and Chris has got experience in interviews anyway. But that was, yeah, really exciting. We learned a lot really, really quickly. Most people we talked to saw value in the idea and wanted to download it. And that was before we had a name, let alone we'd built an app.
SailTies, not the most obvious of titles, perhaps. Just talk us through how you got to where you got to.
So we wanted sailing in the name, obviously. Most people probably know this, but a sail tie is something you use to kind of tie down that extra canvas of a sail to the boom.
Yeah.
We see SailTies as being a place where not only you can record your own sailing, but there's the opportunity there to inspire other sailors and make sailing feel more accessible to more people, get more people involved. So it kind of ties everybody together. So there's a kind of play on the word SailTies there. So we stuck with SailTies.
It's obvious, really, is it? But sometimes it needs explaining just to be clear.
I was going to say exactly what you were about to say. That it was the best option when we were looking for the SailTies domain name. It always suggests all the automatic, like machine learning generated alternatives you could have. And ClothCord was the next best option that was suggested to us. So I think we picked the right one.
Let's just look at the USPs. You've mentioned quite a few of them already, but the very heart of this app, what do you consider to be the absolute USPs that nothing else on the market out there currently offers?
From that user research we did, there's a few guiding points we're sticking to. So I can talk through those and that'll help you understand the USP, I think. So we want to make it really, really easy to capture and share your sailing. So we're trying to keep like a non-fussy, clean user interface to effortlessly capture everything about your voyage and have it in that one place. Right now, if you go out and you try and capture your adventure, you probably end up with a paper logbook in one place. You might have your photos somewhere else. Maybe you take a picture of the chart plotter. But we want to make it really easy and effortless to just keep your photos, the crew that are on board, everything about the voyage, the track, notes about the trip, all in that one place and really accessible. And I think part of that is making it collaborative. So it's generally at least a couple of people on board a boat. So if everyone can work together, it makes it a lot easier and more fun to kind of capture that rich memory of the day. And there's nothing else that's doing that at the moment. Going back to the logbook, we want to make it really fun to look back on your sailing experience. Now, Chris mentioned a spreadsheet. I've seen a bunch of people we've talked to do use a spreadsheet. We used to have one. But with this, you can easily look back on the miles you've logged, the boats you've been on, the locations you've been to. And with that, you can easily share it. So you can share it with your family and friends. And we hope it can help you go sailing more in the future by using that kind of evidence of your experience when you want to go crewing or you want to charter a boat or maybe when you're completing your qualifications. These are all important stats you need to look back at. And right now, you're either adding it up manually with a paper logbook, if you can find them. A lot of people we talked to said they can't find their paper logbooks. They're dotted all around the house and lost in various places, or you're using a spreadsheet. One really key point that's really, really important to us, and it's kind of where it all started when I had that kind of indulgent technology detox in Tuscany, is the ability to get away from technology, like no distractions from sailing. For us, or for me at least anyway, sailing's about mindfulness, a kind of appreciating nature, and just like feeling better connected to our oceans and our planet, and spending quality time with each other and not staring at a phone. So we believe that the app can help people sail more by capturing your experience and using that to find more sailing opportunities. But we 100% think that if people are looking at their phone while they're on the boat, because of us, we've failed. So that's really important for us to use that technology to enable more real life experiences.
What about old trips then? We've all got this, no matter how long you've been sailing or how short, as you quite rightly said, bits of logbooks scattered to the four winds. If you do manage to find all those old logbooks, is there an ability to actually upload without too much difficulty previous trips?
There isn't today, but that's 100% on our list. So we're working for our list of priorities and that one's on there. We've been asked that a few times from a few users. Because obviously when you come to the platform, you want to be able to show all of your sailing experience. We think it'd be a great idea to be able to pull in your sailing qualifications as well, be it from the RYA or the other equivalents. So it's definitely on our list. And I think, yeah, we want to make that really simple and easy for people to do so.
Chris, we talked there about market research. Tom was talking about the help he's been getting from the other half. From your perspective, what about this feedback then from people? Clearly very, very important. I'm presuming you've been getting quite a lot of it from the moment you launched almost.
Yeah, we have, and it's been amazing. It's one of the best parts of the job, I think, is talking to people about sailing and talking to people about the product. One of the things we've learned in our careers is the importance of user-centered design. So not just necessarily building something and hoping that people will come, but actually building what people want. So we talk to our SailTies users on a weekly basis to find out what is and isn't working, so we can iterate quickly and just make sure we're building the best possible app. And in fact, at the beginning, even though we had a wait list of over 700 sailors for our beta version, we made a conscious decision to only onboard 200 people. And we also did that gradually over the season. And the reason we did it was so we could personally speak to all of the ones who replied to us anyway. We owe a lot to the feedback and quite often introductions that we got from those early adopters. Is any of them listening? Kerry, you're one of them. Thank you very much. But what it does do, though, is it teaches you to have a very thick skin. I think it can actually be more uncomfortable for the user at first when we ask them to tell us what they hate about the app and what could be better. Although they do all come round pretty quickly. I don't think any of them hold back. Luckily, overall, yeah, people are really enjoying it.
You're chuckling there, Tom. You've obviously got something to add to that.
Yeah, it's first people are nervous to give you bad feedback. They feel like they're going to upset you or something, but they soon start telling you what they think should be different or what could be better. And that's great. I think the more constructive feedback is the stuff we like to hear most, because how we're going to get better. One thing I've learned building digital products is if you're not embarrassed by the first thing you show to users, you're probably showing it too late. I think there's a lot of value to getting feedback on your ideas really, really early. Even if it's just like a scrappy sketch on a bit of paper, you can learn so much.
I've got to say, some of the things I'm seeing on the app there, I love some of the pictures that people share. There's one I was looking at before we started this podcast today of Thomas Guy, Coyer and four others doing their D Skipper of Gosport to Southampton back in November last year. And all you can see is a pair of eyes looking back at you through the kit they're wearing. And I just think that encapsulates winter sailing on the Solent, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's fantastic. That's one of our favourite things, actually. On the home screen now, we've built a public feed where people can share their voyages if they want. You can keep it private if you also prefer to do that. But it's been really exciting to see the kind of sailing coming in from around the world. When we first built it, like you said, we've had that bigger overview so we could see all the voyages, and that was really fun. But now we're really happy we can share that with other people. So if people do want to share their sailing publicly, it's really great to see these different sailing happening all over the place. We've had sailing on small lakes all the way to, like Chris mentioned, Atlantic crossing. So far we've got 25,000 or just over now nautical miles in six out of the seven continents on the app. So if anybody's sailing in Antarctica, it'd be fantastic to get a voyage record, complete the full seven. That'd be amazing.
What are the biggest challenges that you found of getting into the marketplace with a product like this?
I think the biggest challenge with any sailing product, I'm sure other people you've spoken to felt the same, is that no matter how hard us sailors try, it just isn't an everyday activity. For some of our users, they only sail a handful of times a year. They might do a couple of holidays and that's everything for them. So whilst this is something we actually want to improve for sailors in the future, the challenge it poses for us today is just how do we make sure sailors remember to use SailTies? That's one of the reasons we're focusing on creating an app that lets you engage with the sailing community when you're off the water and therefore keep us top of mind for next time you cast off. So that public feed that Tom mentioned, it lets you see what other local sailors are up to, but also you can discover new destinations from sailors all around the world. As we're speaking to you now, like we're just releasing commenting, so sailors can ask questions about passages or just congratulate each other on great trips. And then we're also working closely with sailing clubs and schools at the moment to build features that let their members or their customers share sailing with each other in a new and exciting way they've not been able to do before. So we've got really great feedback actually on our idea for a club page with a feed of the club's members' voyages and like a members' leaderboard and a bunch of other ideas. So we hope that those sort of things will give sailors more reason to remember, I guess, to record their sailing with us.
It's a good point you make. Many of us are now using, of course, RYAC tracks. It's a replacement, as we all know, for the CG66 from the Coast Guard. I think most of the time we remember to switch that on. But as you say, it is actually then engaging and reminding yourself in a way that actually there is this app as well. So I don't think there's an easy way, really, of keeping it as front of mind for people that literally you start the engine, you cast the lines off, the crew are all good to go, and remembering to hit the app. Any other thoughts or ideas of actually helping that along?
Well, it's always quite, like you mentioned, it's always quite a busy situation when you're leaving a dock. You're trying to take into account the wind, the tide. You don't want to smash your boat into someone else's. So the last thing you're going to think about is sail ties, probably. So a couple of things we're thinking about at the moment, which we're talking to a couple of users about, is the ability to maybe set a predefined time that you're going to depart, or even start recording in the car park before you get on the boat. And then to accompany that, the ability to trim the track afterwards. So you could just take off that first part, walking to the boat and getting onto it. And then also at the end of the day, you don't have to worry about stopping it when you're trying to safely moor your boat into a marina. Probably one of the most stressful pieces of sailing.
I'm sure in time it'll just be integrated into everything on board, all the onboard systems. There it will be, the sail ties. When you're starting the engine, start your sail ties.
If you compare that to Strava's model for cycling, I think the majority of people don't actually use the Strava app. They might have a bike computer or a smartwatch. That's definitely the vision for SailTies as well. We wouldn't take it personally if you didn't even use our app to record your sailing. If you did use the chart plotter or a navigation app, if you happen to be using one that day, that's fine. Dinghy sailors, I'm sure wearable technology is most appropriate for them. And then we've also had like really great conversations with some smart boat companies where the boat would be doing it for you essentially. And then SailTies would act more of just the place where you get to store all of your sailing together, regardless of which boat you're on, who you were crewing with, how you recorded it. It's the place where it all comes together.
What about then the core element to all of this? Because nothing happens without some cash. How are you funded? How are you going to be funded going forward? What are the opportunities for people to get involved?
As you mentioned, we built the beta app ourselves in our spare time, and it's been completely bootstrapped so far. So it's been evenings and weekends. We recently quit our jobs the end of last year. So we're now full time on SailTies. And as part of that, we're doing a pre-seed raise. So we've got some savings we're burning through at the moment, and that's going to get us through most of this year. But yeah, we are doing a pre-seed raise at the moment. We're looking to raise £150,000. We've currently got to just over 100,000. So there is still space to get involved. So if anybody's listening and do want to get involved in investing, they can get us on hello@sailties.net. Yeah, so that's the plan. And that will get us about a year to really nail this Strava sailing.
That's really exciting to be talking to you as we were this time last year. And it was all so new and so emerging to get to where you are. Both of you must be so pleased to be in the position you're now in.
Yeah, it is amazing. It's very exciting. It's not just investors that we're looking out for as well. You mentioned about how people can help. As we're building these new sailing club features, we're also talking to a lot of clubs and sailing schools and sailing groups as well. I don't think I really appreciated that many of those existed before we started doing this. So we've spoken to She Captain, which is sort of a group of female sailors, and other organisations like that, like Clean Sailors. So if there are people who think SailTies will be a great way to share sailing between members of a club or a group or a boat owners association that they're part of, then we'd love to hear from them as well. So I mentioned the emails, hello@sailties.net. But I think first and foremost, like for any sailors listening, obviously just download the app, give it a try. It's free. So try it out on your next sail.
Where is that going to lead in terms of monetization, guys? Because free is a lovely thing, but clearly somewhere down the line, you're going to have to monetize this model somewhere.
So in terms of monetization, what we've built so far, we want to keep that free forever, if we can, and I think we can. So the ability to record all of your sailing, have it in one place, and have that be a really useful way to share your experience in the future, we want to keep that completely free. But what we are going to do is take a similar model to Strava, where you have this premium layer, which helps you just get a bit more value out of your voyages. Maybe we could overlay some weather data or pull in some more data points and more stats about your sailing. One thing that we've been prototyping that people like the look of is the ability to group voyages into a trip. It's quite nice to have these individual voyages, but if you group them all into like a week's worth of sailing around Sardinia or something, a nice interactive map that can make part of the premium service. Part of that this first year is to figure out what those features are and to figure out how we can keep the free version valuable while also creating this kind of profitable premium layer.
You've mentioned all the way through about the partnerships between the users, the partnerships between the tech side, if you will, but also I presume that some partnerships may have emerged with others in this marketplace. I'm thinking now about Imre, Savvy Navi, people like that.
There's lots of opportunities. One of the best parts of this whole journey, I think, is some of the great conversations we've had with other people in the sailing world. So from tech companies, smart boat companies, some of the apps like, you know, Navily, those kind of apps, the boat owner associations, we've spoken to people at the RYA and even like North Sails, all over the place, like such a broad spectrum. And the recurring theme is that, yeah, this is something that obviously needs to exist. People want it. And hopefully there's loads of ways that we can integrate into other products or just support other organizations. So like for sailing clubs, the idea is it would be free for them to have a page on SailTies, and it'll just make, it's just another awesome way for them to engage with their members.
So for the last question for today's podcast with Business on Board, let's get in the DeLorean time machine, gentlemen, and take ourselves forward. What are we looking at, and what's the success criteria look like for you?
Well, I think there's a big future for sailing. I think right now it feels quite intimidating to get into. It seems quite expensive. And I think more than that, and I've heard it a lot lately, is that from non-sailors, as well as my own personal experience, people just don't consider it as something they can do. You kind of see the boats in the marinas and you think, oh, it doesn't even enter your mind that you could be getting involved in that. It just feels completely like a different world. But actually, sailing's affordable. It has amazing benefits. Like I mentioned before, you get more in touch with nature. You get to spend real quality time with people. I think if you're spending a week on board a boat with six people and you've got a kitchen the size of a telephone box, you're going to bond. It's a great way to get to know each other. But sailing's also, it's challenging. You've got to take into account the tide, the wind, other boats, all these things. There's so many benefits from that, and we want other people to experience that. So we've talked about SailTies being the Strava of sailing, and that's what we're working on at the moment, and we're going to focus on that. But we see it as a stepping stone to something much bigger, really, and that's to help people go sailing more.
Just to follow on from what Tom said, so yeah, I think to help people go sailing more, which will make sailing more accessible, we just want to make going sailing easy. So like as easy as, I don't know, booking cinema tickets. I think the idea is that while our sailors will be building up their SailTies profiles, which effectively are their sailing CVs, they'll be able to use those to get more opportunities to go out on the water. Just take crewing, for example, which is probably the cheapest way of going sailing as crew for somebody else. Currently, it's a very difficult and frustrating process. So there's countless Facebook groups and crewing websites with people looking for sailing opportunities on a daily basis. But it's really hard to know who you're meeting, what their experience is like, if the type of sailing is really what you're after. Both Tom and I have been stood up at marinas quite a few times. Tom's been on holiday in Italy where he thought he was going on an amazing sail, but he was actually just going on a cocktail tasting day by the look of it with the engine. So if sailors have these verifiable sailing profiles on SailTies, you know, this will be a much smoother and safer process. And I think, you know, beyond that, we can use our knowledge of people sailing on our platform to actually suggest stuff to them. So to educate people about how to get into sailing and then what the next steps which should be to improve. So whether that's a sailing school, chartering or crewing. So just revolutionize that journey of how people discover, but then also improve at sailing.
Gentlemen, it's been real inspiration talking to you both today. Thank you both so very much in giving us your time and talking more about SailTies and about where this app potentially can go and is already starting to get such great traction out there. Thousands of miles already under its belt. I think that's the proof of the pudding is always in the eating as to how much people are actually using a product and getting something out of it, and clearly people are. So fantastic work. Well done to both of you for the commitment, both financial and literally just getting it off the ground. So well done, guys. Thank you for listening to today's show. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please do leave me some feedback, and if you feel so disposed, perhaps rate the show with 5 stars. Whichever platform you use to listen to your favourite podcasts, if you'd like to hear more from some of my featured guests, just search for Kerry Hurford-Jones. That's C-E-R-I, Hurford-Jones, or Business on Board. Let's catch up again soon.
Business on Board with Kerry Hurford-Jones.